Australia. It's a cruel place full of deadly animals and savage citizens wearing bear undershirts and wrestling crocodiles. Or so I thought. The name's Dustin Prince, detective at the Chicago Police Department. It was a sunny Tuesday, much like any other, and I was sitting on my back veranda, sipping a cup of Earl Grey tea. I was sipping my beverage when I was abruptly interrupted by a loud panic knock at my door.
Oh, Detective Prince, thank goodness you're here.
What seems to be the problem, ma'am?
Oh, Detective, I've been searching high and low, and I just can't find one.
Find one what exactly?
An Australian.
What could this Australian have possibly done to this poor damsel? Loved her? Robbed her? Shot her parents in a dark alley after a family evening at an opera? What sort of cruel human would ever?
No.
What?
I just wanted an Australian to be my boyfriend. That's all.
Oh. I didn't know much about Australians, and I was still confused as to why this woman was standing on my porch asking to help her find a foreign suitor. After all, I'm a detective, not a matchmaker. I'm sorry, ma'am, but I can't—
Thank you, detective. I knew I could trust you. Here's my phone number, address, mobile number, email, birth date, social security number, sandwich preference, and everything else you need to know. Thanks!
Wait! What's your name, anyway?
The name's Lovegood. Amanda Lovegood.
Right, I'll keep in touch, Miss Lovegood.
Thanks, Detective Prince. Owen. Nice slippers, by the way. They match the color of your eyes.
Have a nice day, Miss Lovegood.
And with that, I was on the case. I had a stack of papers, a woman in need of my help, and a handful of blue vein cheese. And above all, I had no idea what an Australian was. So how was I supposed to find one if I didn't even know what I was looking for? Well, if I didn't know what an Australian was, it was time to go find out. Initiate search for the Opal Wombat, the Australian man that will become lover to Miss Amanda Lovegood. And the best way to learn about Australians is through an epic montage. Cue music. As my great-great-grandfather, Seymour Prince, taught me, the best way to find someone is to make them come to you. And thanks to the media, I now know everything there was to know about Australians. So through my ancestors' knowledge and a quick trip down to the local Aussie souvenir store, I put together a facade that could lure an Australian from 40 miles away. And with that, the search for the Opal Wombat began. G'day mate, how's it going? Would any of you blow it so Shilas like to duck around my place with some shrimp on the barbie?
She made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast. And she said, do you come from a land down under?
Oigo!
Crikey, isn't today just a rip out of the day? Now, do any of you know where I can get some Tucker? What in the... As the hours ticked by, I noticed that I wasn't grabbing the attention of any Australians.
Nah, she's right, mate. Accidents happen. I'm pretty sure you didn't mean it.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, mister. I didn't mean to drop your, what is that thing anyway? Is it like a black market hot dog or something?
Well, it's actually a little dish I brought from home. It's a foreign recipe. You wouldn't understand it. At least with that get up, maybe you should.
You found one! I knew I could trust you, Detective Prince.
Hold on, so you're an Australian?
Yeah.
But you're not wearing an undershirt and flip-flops.
Yeah.
And you look like you've never wrestled a crocodile day in your life.
Yeah.
And you're dressed like a normal person.
Yeah.
So you're telling me that not all Australians wear undershirts and flip-flops. They don't all wrestle crocodiles for a living. They don't all ride kangaroos to work. They don't all live in the outback. And they dress and act like normal humans?
Yeah.
I need to find me a European.
So what did you say your name was again?